Welcome to the Unleash podcast, where we believe that life is better when it is lived on purpose. My name is Molly Brunk, and I am joined with lead pastor of Be Hope Church, Brad Thompson. Brad, how in the world are you?
Hopefully not looking pasty today.
Hopefully not looking pale. Brad's very tan today. He went to the tanning booth right before this podcast, and he has a nice gleam to him.
I do not tan. Okay, let's be clear.
It's a rumor that we're starting, so.
It would be the first time, but I do not tan.
I actually book his appointments at LA Tan for him, so it's fine. He's just kind of embarrassed about it, but no, he does not tan, but we're starting a new series today. We're going to interrupt our guest series.
We are.
We're just kind of doing whatever we want to at this point.
It's our podcast, Molly.
It's true. Whatever
we want.
If you're confused, sorry.
Well, to be fair, we didn't tell them that there was going to be like, it was going to go on forever.
That's true. So. We didn't interrupt anything. We're just now starting a new series.
Who do you?
Tell us about what the series is, and then we'll get into our fumble moment.
Yeah, we're doing a new series called Emphasis Matters. Emphasis Matters. And today's episode, I want to talk about where's your focus. I want to talk about focus today.
Focus. Focus.
Focus.
You love focus.
I love the word focus.
I know. I'm excited to hear about it. But we do have a fumble moment. And this one, no one really is embarrassed by this one. This one's more of just like a pet peeve, I feel like. Fair?
Well, I could give you an example of the fact that I think I have ADD or ADHD.
Oh, okay.
But that's not the kind of focus we're talking about today.
Fair.
So that wouldn't be a bad fumble moment.
All right. So then.
So when we get on that focus, mm-hmm. I'll talk about that. But okay. I want to talk about the four words I hate to hear.
All right. I'm excited. I'm excited to hear what you hate.
I'm going to smile when I say it because I know like I come across as a jerk when I say this. So let me just say this. I'll smile and say it. Four words I can't stand to hear are we can't do that.
We can't do that. That's,
I mean, it's technically five with a contraction. Technically five with a contraction, but we'll go with four.
All right.
We can't do that.
Do you want to expound on that?
Yeah. So often there'll be times when we're dreaming about, I love what we do, Be Hope. We think about big events, big things that are going to happen. Thinking about the future, we think really big. And sometimes people, as we dream big, will say things like, nah, we don't have the gifting for that. Mm. We don't have the tools for that. We don't have the right people. We don't have the right this. We don't have the right that. And this is my least favorite thing to hear.
It really irks you.
Yeah. This is what I love about our producer. You don't get to see Matt Scruggs very often. But what I love about Matt Scruggs is he will stop people mid-meeting and say, I don't think we should say that. Let's talk about what we can do.
Mm, that's good.
And that's what I want to talk about today.
I'm excited then. I mean, Matt is kind of the best, so.
He really is the best.
Like, he's shaking his head no right now.
He's one of my favorites.
I know.
I know I say that about everybody.
It's true, but he really is. He really is.
So are you.
He's like, I'll say that to everyone, but you really are, Matt. So we love Matt. But all right, let us know where we are heading today.
Yeah, main idea today is this is your focus, and this is common sense. Your focus defines your future. And this is why this matters, is because outcomes aren't fixed, but they're focus-driven. This is so important. The outcomes of our life, I believe, are not fixed, but they're focus-driven. And I hear people say all the time as an excuse, well, this is the way I was wired, and this is the way I was born, and this is just who I am, and it's an excuse to be rude and mean and to be lazy and all those things. Just what I do. No, that's not who you are. Like, you're using who you think you are as an excuse not to do what you could do. Mm. Does this make sense?
Yeah.
No, I do need to pause. And we were talking about this before the show. I have acknowledged that there are people in life who have not been dealt the greatest hand. Like, we've talked about working in the hood, working in poverty, and I get it. There are times in life where people are not dealt the same cards. And so I want to be fair in that and just acknowledge that. But I also think there are times in life where we could potentially step into a greater future, but it's hard for us to do that because our focus is in the wrong place.
Yeah. No, that's good.
So does it make sense?
Yep, it makes sense. Do you have some good examples?
I love examples. This is one of my favorites. My wife is a teacher, and she has a teacher friend who was talking about her son. They were at, I think, a skating rink, and he came out, and he's like, "Mom, look, I found the world's biggest Band-Aid." And he had this Band-Aid on his arm, and when she looks down, he had unwrapped a tampon.
No, it's not a tampon. It's a maxi pad.
It's a maxi pad. Yeah.
I was like, I don't know how that would work.
You think about a fumble moment. This is it. Yes, that's what I meant to say. It was a maxi pad. He had unwrapped a maxi pad and put it on his arm. I don't know where he found the maxi pad. It was in the locker. It was unused. Let's be clear about that. But he had unwrapped it, put it on his arm. And he's like, "Mom, I found the world's biggest Band-Aid." And she's like, mortified. And the point was, this is like, what she saw as a maxi pad, like, he saw as a Band-Aid. And I love that example of like, oh, just like, no, that's not, no, it's not a Band-Aid. Mm-hmm. And he's like, "No, Mom, this could do exactly what I need it to do.
This could save my life.
It's like a mini tourniquet." I love that. I think another example, this is a biblical example. And I know that we have people who are listening who are not Christians. But there's a really cool story in the Bible, one of my favorites, of a guy named Joseph. And it's fascinating to me that you read his entire story. You talk about somebody who's on the struggle bus. I mean, this kid's hated. He gets basically sold into slavery by his brothers. He gets falsely accused of things. He gets put in jail for 2 years. Like, it's a ridiculous story. And then you get into the end of his life, and he names his kid Manasseh. And I love the name, means God made me forget all my trouble. Mm. And I did a message on this.
You did?
Called the God who made me. And I think some people heard me incorrectly. That does happen from time to time.
Sometimes, yeah.
I was pointing out that he's had all these traumatic events in his life. And the power of what he is declaring in this moment is he's not ignoring the trauma that he went through. Some people heard me say that I'm like overlooking people's trauma.
Yeah.
That was not the point. The point Joseph is making is that through the trauma, his greatest focus was not on his problem, but his greatest focus was on God. And so when he names his son, "God made me forget," he's not saying, "I forgot everything that happened to me, or I should ignore it." He's saying, no, that through all the struggles, my focus was always on God. Mm. And I love that.
Yeah. Like,
his focus defined his future. And in the end, he became second in command.
Mm-hmm.
And I love that. And that's what I want for people. I want for people to begin to think about, let's just be real. Like, life is not a piece of cake.
Mm-hmm.
I think so oftentimes what happens is we get focused on our problems and not the opportunities. And you hear me say this often, problems are rich soil for opportunity. And I think one of the questions that I want our listeners to ask is this is just a great question. Are you someone who generally focuses on the problem, or are you somebody who is focusing on the opportunity?
Yeah.
In your work environments, or even at home, or wherever you are you somebody when there's a big idea thrown out, are you somebody who says, "Nope, can't do that," mm-hmm, without even thinking about the potential of what could happen? Or are you somebody who says, like Matt Scruggs, "Hey, let's think about what we could do."
Mm-hmm.
We may not be able to pull that thing off,
mm-hmm,
but what I love about with Matt is that we often find ourselves going in another direction, and often it's better than what we originally dreamed, simply because we went down that route.
Yeah. No, I think that's good. And I think a lot of our meetings turn into that. But it's hard to not get stuck in the how, and you want to make it realistic immediately. And maybe if you're looking at your surroundings with only as problems, mm-hmm, of all of the things that you're going to have to do now, I think it definitely limits where the conversation can go. So, but I think also too, it's hard to say, "Oh, all of the time I'm problems," or "all of the time I'm opportunities." I think that every situation you can react differently, but I think always asking yourself that question of what your focus is changes that. But what's at stake?
Yeah, here's what's at stake is focus is what differentiates success from standard.
Hmm.
I think so many times the standard is that the average person is going to focus on, this is the problem we have. This is what we're going to do. We're going to just live in this for a few minutes. And they never really think outside that. I was talking with somebody the other day, a problem they were facing at work. And it was amazing to me how much conversation was had around the issue, but not around solving the issue. Like it is, let's just be blunt. It's more fun to talk about a problem than it is to think about the future.
Yeah.
And that's the standard, I think, for most people. I don't know, B-Hope's a great place to work, but I would guess in a lot of places you go, there's a lot of backbiting and fighting and just gossip and constant discussions about what's wrong with this and what's wrong with that, but nobody's making it better.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's why I say the difference between the average person and success is all their focus.
Mm-hmm. I feel like that's why a reality TV works so well, because they just stay in their problems and no one's looking to move towards solutions or resolutions or forgiveness or anything like that. It's like, oh, let's talk about the problem 10 different ways from 10 different perspectives over and over for an entire episode. And that's where we land.
So. Yeah, that's what makes for great TV, apparently.
Apparently.
That's why I never watch it.
You only watch to
educational
learn.
Stuff.
I told Brad this. I said that he makes boring things fun, but fun things boring, because he only watches shows to learn or only reads books to learn. How boring is that? But then you make mundane things fun, like meetings or boring things.
I do my best. I do want to talk about this, though. Like, this is not something that, this is something that we've actually been through recently. You and I, during Easter weekend, had a great chance to catch up. Am I allowed to share this?
Yeah.
I'm going to share it anyway. We were in the middle of some transition with some staff during Easter weekend. Out of all weekends, that's the crazy weekend to have staff transitions. And you asked me, do you remember this? You're like, how you feeling?
Uh-huh.
And I was like, I feel better than I have in like the last 2 years. Like, I know it's crazy. I know we're missing people. I know it's kind of just nuts at this point. But what I loved was in the middle of that loss, we were focusing on what could happen. Mm-hmm. And I think I told you, like, we're going to grow this team in this season.
Yep.
We're going to make things happen. We're going to change processes and systems. Like, there are so many great things that are already happening.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, you can focus on transition, and transition is hard, or you could focus on what's the difference that we could make in this season. So let me put it like this. I think in transition, the standard is, let's just wait until somebody else new comes in. Let's let them make the changes. And in this time, I'm like, no, that's what the standard is. Success is, no, let's take the time that we have and let's begin to change things. And so like in this season of the last 3-4 months, we've grown this team by a significant number of people. I think it's significant, especially when you don't have a leader there.
Yeah.
We've grown the team. We've changed onboarding processes for people. We've made it easier. We've changed the way that we communicate with the team. And I think those were all opportunities that needed to be capitalized on in the middle of this problem.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's, I think, because your focus was future, that the leaders, because we didn't have a paid leader there, but we had leaders running that team. And I think they were able to focus on, oh, what could be. And that's how it like kept moving forward and stuff.
And they've done an awesome job.
Yeah. They really have.
Awesome job.
Yeah. So I think that's a great example. But what can we do now?
I love it. Here's 3 simple things. In order to allow the focus to become the center of where you need to go, 3 things. Number 1, define the problem. I know that seems crazy, but I heard somebody say this the other day. I love it. A well-defined problem is half solved. And so if you can define the problem, your work is halfway over. I love that. Define the problem. Number 2 is envision the potential. So you have to define the problem, but envision the potential. Where do we go? Where do we want to go? What are the opportunities that are in front of us? What are the things that we can improve? Remember, this is the difference between success and standard is your focus. What are the things that we can control? What are the things that we can focus on? And where could we potentially be in the future, even though we're in this struggle? Envision the potential. And then my 3rd one is important, and I know it feels like semantics, but I think this is so key. You plan for the potential and not for the problem.
Hmm.
Plan for the potential and not the problem. And I think so often what happens is we try to solve the problem, right? but we're not actually preparing for the future in that. Let me explain it like this. It's like somebody who needs surgery. Like sometimes I'll hear people say, oh, I need knee surgery. Why do you need knee surgery? Well, I just want my knee fixed. Yeah, that's fine. And then what I see is people get their knees fixed and they haven't thought past what mm-hmm. happens after the surgery mm-hmm. versus somebody who is solving for the future and solving for the potential says, no, I want to run around with my grandkids mm-hmm. or I want to run around with my kids. Mm-hmm. And so once the surgery happens, it's like, oh, no, there's still work that needs to be done. Yeah. I've got rehab. I've got therapy. I've got doctor's appointments. Mm-hmm. And there's this plan for a greater future, not just solving the initial problem. Does this make sense?
Yeah.
Do you need another example? Should I give you another one? Or are you good?
Maybe give one more.
Let me talk about it in terms of business and numbers. If you say our numbers are down, in one of our ministry areas. Hey, the numbers are down, and it's like, well, I think the tendency, the standard, is to solve the problem by going back to what got you where you are. Mm. So instead of dreaming the future, we go back to the system that got us to the point where we are, thinking that's going to solve the problem. Instead of thinking about the potential of how do we capitalize on changing the system and the process that not only moves us past the problem, but beyond the standard of where we were. Does this make sense?
Yeah, makes sense. That's great. No, I think that makes total sense in focusing on the future and focusing on the potential, I think just helps you keep moving forward. And so, do you have any final thoughts?
No, I would just say this. In moments where you're frustrated, it feels like things aren't moving forward, just remember the outcomes aren't fixed, but the focus is what drives it. Mm-hmm. Outcomes aren't fixed, but they're focus-driven. And your focus always defines the future. And that would be the key. So define the problem, envision the potential, and solve for the potential, not the problem.
That's good. You ready for some hope or nopes?
Let's do it.
All right. Every episode we wrap up with hope or nopes, and we just give Brad some topics and he lets us know if it's hope for it or nope for it. And the first one is the Summer Olympics of 2024.
Let's do it. I'm hope.
Hope for
always
it.
Always Olympics.
All right. It's Paris this year. You want to go?
I was going to try to say something in Italian, and French.
And French. Oh my, Atlanta.
French. Rome, Paris. He's like, Rome's Italy. Paris is France. French.
Oh shoot. Oui. Okay. And then the next one is they're gonna have flag football at the 2028 Summer Olympics.
I'm game.
That's hope for you.
It's a hope for me. Here's why. My niece plays flag football.
Really?
And I'm gonna brag on her because she's athletic.
That's so cool.
She was playing the other day and a coach told her, if she continues, she could get a scholarship in the future for it.
That's so cool. Yeah. I did not know that like flag football was
legit.
I had no idea.
I'm hope for it.
Hasn't come to our town yet. We got to make it come to our town.
Well, she's on the West Coast. And so, you know, typically when
starts
it's,
over there.
When it's out of fad.
When it's not as trendy anymore.
When it's not as trendy in the West Coast,
then comes
that's
to the
when
Midwest.
We pick it up, yeah.
Yeah. Midwest is best. It's okay. All right. Last one is the NFL specifically choosing the Chiefs schedule based off of Taylor Swift's performing schedule. What do you think about that? Is that hope for it, note for it, so that she can be at more games?
I think it's genius. I'll give it hope.
I'm just saying the amount of viewers for the NFL has skyrocketed thanks
it's
to
all
her.
About the mo. And I'm not talking about momentum.
The NFL money. Has one focus and one focus only. So
that's true.
All right. Well, all three hopes. That never happens.
Your focus defines your future.
Wow. I love that. Hey, thank you so much for listening to this episode. Make sure that you like and subscribe and share it with everyone in your sphere of influence. And we'll see you back here on the next episode.